Yeah, it's been a while since we had a funny moment. Well, has it? I mean, the past two parts, if I recall, were more serious, weren't they?
Tadaima kaerimashita.
Oh?
What is it?
Ah, nanda, temei ka. Iya, ima omae no tonari ni onna no ko ga tatte ita kiga shita nda yo.
Feel like? Speak of the devil, we go into serious moment. This time really did come. I'm struck by grief right here.
Nanda yo, sonna shiketa tara sunna yo. Kusso, iradatsu na.
He likes the cigarette in his mouth. God, a lighter doesn't really start up.
Zutto kesa kara kou da ze. Nanka totemo iya na kanji da. Machigaete sanai no pan demo kuchimai sou na kibun da ze.
Hey, where's Sanae-san? Sanae-san, not Sanae, Sanae, I think it is. Perhaps Sanae-san also.
Na, iru yo. Kusso. Konna toki wa kore shika nei.
Takes up a bat from under the cash register.
Gaki domo aite ni katto shite kuru ka?
Wait, the way he words that is as if he's saying, I'm gonna swing this bat around, knock out a bunch of kids, and then knock myself out. Passing by Fuku, he leaves the shop. After that, hearing that loud voice, Fuku's body shudders. Pops is screaming. Was he my dad? Well, no, not even close. My dad would scream much louder than that. That was pathetic compared. Fuku stands there dumbfounded. That was for your sake. I think it's because he likes you.
Dattara, ureshii desu.
Turning around to those sounds, Sanae-san has come down to the floor. Sanae-san.
Ano? Okaeri nasai, Tomoya-san.
Sanae-san smiles sweetly, and then...
Fuko-chan?
That name comes out of her mouth. Ah, thank goodness. Sanae-san still remembers her.
Tadaima desu. Fuko-chan?
She repeats it again. Sanae-san?
Mata, watashi no pan wo tabete kuremasu ka?
In haste, she runs to pick up a tray without responding to Fuku.
Ikutsu desu ka? Takusan desu ka? Onaka ippai ni naru to yūhan hairanai desu yo. Kore gurai ni shite okimashou ne.
She piles up a mountain of bread and turns our way. And she picks up one of them and presents it. Sadly, she brings them towards the wrong direction. Her arms tremble and the bread falls down. Sanae-san. That's enough now, Sanae-san.
Mada... iru n desu yo ne, Fuko-chan wa.
Yes, she is right by me. Damn it, Lag. Don't ruin the moments. You do this every time. God damn it, Lag. That face, man. That face.
Fuko-chan.
One lagging moment of insanity. Well, not really. Just a clusterfuck there.
Fuko-chan, kite kudasai.
Fuku comes close. Sanae-san brings her arms to hug Fuku. Gah, those arms pass right through her. Even then, Sanae-san continues, holding nothing in her hands.
Fuko-chan, zutto... この家にいてもいいですからね。明夫さんも、私も、渚も、みんな、風子ちゃんのこと、家族だと思ってます。ずっと、いてくださいね。
Fuku smiles, being enveloped in kindness. How kind this family is. But now, that time has come.Entering her room, I call her. The room's atmosphere is closed.
Tomoya-kun.
Her girl looks at me with only her eyes from the futon. Her eyes and face are red. A fever. Hey, Furukawa. Coming right by her side, I kneel down. The day after tomorrow's Kyoko-san's wedding. You remember?
Hi.
Good. Furukawa, we should congratulate her from now on. You shouldn't force yourself. Sleeping here is fine.
Hi.
All right then, head to sleep. Don't think of anything but getting better. Okay?
Hi.
Come on, close your eyes.
Tomoya-kun.
What is
it?
Alright. I grasp the thin white hand Furukawa brings out to me. Dude, you're not even going after her this time around. No, no, don't ruin the scene now. She closes her eyes as if relieved. The tears in her eyes run down. Fuku walks in front of me and kneels down like I did. In her hand is a starfish. She quietly places it by Furukawa's bedside. I guess so. Furukawa also really liked that starfish. Furukawa's small sleeping noises continues. Hey, Fuku, wanna go to the school? She thinks for a bit, then nods. It's just that I can never come back to the calm days with this family. That's all. Alright, let's go. We'll go sneak into the school during this time and stick around until morning. We should try not to get caught by the teachers on night watch, though. But something like this buys me up somehow. Holding on to Fuku's hand, we go into the empty school. Now, those of you who have seen the anime, this is obviously kind of different, you know, because in the anime version, both Tomoya and Nagisa went with Fuku to the school, but it's just Tomoya in the original visual novel here, and then the classroom in the old school building. We really managed to get in. There's a sound beside me going. Looking there, Fuku is ripping up the paper bag she was holding at her chest. She takes the birthday set from inside and puts it on top of the desk. Hey, Fuku, you're pretty hasty. Oh man, you're such a kid. I don't want to be told that by someone who gets excited over opening her toy wrapper. That's because you're a kid. I try picking up the things on top of the desk. They're here. After putting them down, I try having Fuku wear the trichome.
Okazaki-san, Fuku's treasure, don't take it.
If you're an adult, deal with it.
Fuku, instantly becomes a child.
Next time, because I felt like it. See you next time. Besides, I mean, this wrap-up hasn't really got all that long to go, I don't think. So yeah, see you next time.